Oh, Lord. The Dow tumbled yesterday, shot back up today. It's down about 7% this month. So how do you keep your money safe in uncertain times? Joining me now, National Taxpayers Union Senior Fellow and Center for a Free Economy Board Member, Mattie Duppler is back. Welcome back, Mattie.
Hey, Kennedy.
So a lot of people are looking at this. They're checking their 401ks, and they're kind of freaking out. What should people do?
Well, first, they should stop freaking out. Everybody, just be cool. There's two reasons that people need to look at this with a little bit of sober reflection. One is that price in stocks really isn't that relevant. What matters when it comes to the stock market is the price of a stock relative to the value of that stock. And remember, this year we saw for the first time companies reach trillion-dollar values. That's Amazon and Apple, of course, big tech stocks. And those are massive valuations. Mm-hmm. So in some sense, it's not totally surprising that at some point the stock market had to cool down a little bit. And you saw Trump, too, talk a little bit about context. Context matters when it comes to the stock market. For too long, we've been conflating the stock market and our economy rather than looking at the stock market
but
for what it is.
But the president does take credit for it when the stock market goes up. Will he take responsibility when it flattens?
Well, and this is the question that all observers have been asking all year, which is when is the stock market finally going to price in all of this trade anxiety? We've been waiting for months for the market to finally start to behave in a way that prices that is. That is, I think, a major factor in what we've seen this week. Now, you mentioned before that all of October we've seen a lot of volatility. Mm-hmm. But remember, the fall is generally, September and October are generally pretty volatile months for the stock market. End of October, we generally see a little bit of an uptick. But September was not as bad as anticipated. So again, I go back to my original point that stock market movement is relative. We thought we would see a little bit more of a downfall in September. We didn't see that. We're seeing it now in October ahead of a midterm where you heard from the president, Democrats may take control of the House, in which case we'll certainly see some of the economic fundamental policies shift, tax reform, regulatory reform, all of the things that have contributed to positive stock market conditions. That certainly is in danger when it comes to the midterms.
So you're saying that I should grow a victory garden and put all my money in gold?
I think what you need to do, if you are someone who is looking at this and you're anxious about the stock market, you need to ask yourself what your goals are with your investment. Talk to your financial manager and ask, are my goals being met? If your goals are long-term growth, which generally should be your goal if you are investing in the stock market, you don't need to worry about 1 month dip on the numbers. That certainly isn't something that should worry about you.
We're playing long ball here, Mattie.
That's exactly right. Years and years. When you want to be in the stock market, you want to be looking years ahead. So don't be worried about 1 month at a time.
It's raining men and money always on the show. Mattie Duppler, thank you so much.
That's why I come back, Kennedy.
That's
thanks
right.
a lot.
Thank you. Coming up, Kanye West has just made a huge political announcement. I'll tell you about his plans and get reaction from the panel next.